Hi, my name is Diana and welcome to Real Help. In today's episode, I will teach you everything you need to know about apricot jelly, what fruits are best to use, how long they should be boiled, and of course, my everlasting problem, the texture. First, there are four sectors, let's say, of jams. 1. Jelly, 2. Jam, 3. Marmalade, and 4. Majun. Each has a unique making process. Jelly resembles the candied fruits. Big chunks of fruit, or the whole fruit, in a thick sugary sauce. It's the sweetest of them all and requires the biggest amount of sugar to prepare it. The majority prefers the fruits to be almost intact after boiling, but this is optional and it can be made on your liking. The best fruits to use for jelly are those who have just begun to ripe. Jam, unlike jelly, is spreadable, has the consistency of a thick paste, and it isn't the sweetest jelly. The best jam is made from overripe fruits, boiled enough to make a thick but yet soft mixture. Marmalade is similar in consistency with jam. It's also spreadable, but again not as sweet as jelly. It has a different process in making than jam or jelly because it requires sieving in addition to boiling. Majun is a fruit paste made exclusively from plums. It can be made with very little sugar or with no sugar at all. It takes a long time to boil and it can be difficult to preserve if no sugar is added. Sugar being used in jams and jellies not only for the sweet taste but also for the preserving characteristic. That being said, let's jump to the recipe. You'll need 3 kg or 6.6 pounds of apricots, 3 kg or 6.6 pounds of sugar, 1 lemon, 10 grams or 1 teaspoon of lemon salt. If you don't have any lemon salt, replace it with the juice from another lemon. Optional, you could also add vanilla pods, 1 or 2 pods, and 100 grams or 3 ounces of apricot kernels if you like the almondy taste. The rule is quite simple, for every kilogram of fruit, you add the same amount of sugar. Wash the apricots thoroughly. Unfortunately, my apricots have seen better days. Even with treatments, my apricot tree still had some issues, none of which affected the taste. They are edible and have a strong tasty flavor, but they do have some scars. Dry them with a paper towel and chop them. Add sugar after each layer of fruits. You'll need a large bowl or a pot to hold all the fruits and sugar. Before we advance with the storage, make sure you have sterilized jars or glass containers to preserve your work. If you need help with this process, check out my video on sterilizing jars in the oven. When you finish the apricots, cover the pot and set it aside for 24 hours in a cool, shady spot. Do not refrigerate them. This is how it looks after exactly 24 hours. The apricots and sugar produced a lot of liquid. Put them to boil and add the juice from a lemon. If you want to keep the apricot shape and you want the candied fruit look, put them to boil on the maximum setting on your stove and shake the pot like this to blend the mixture and avoid any crushing. Water the pot's pulp with a wet brush to prevent the sugar from burning. Not only that burnt sugar will darken the jelly, but will also give a bitter flavor. Let them boil for 20 minutes on a big flame while removing all the foam. It will make a lot of foam, especially if you boil it on a high setting, so make sure you have a large pot or this will happen. If you are a beginner or if you don't care about the shape of the fruits and you prefer a spreadable jelly rather than whole fruits, let them boil on low setting, occasionally stirring in the pot to avoid sticking. Let it boil for 35 minutes. After 20 minutes or 35 if you are following the second option, turn off the stove and let the jelly rest for 25 minutes. After 25 minutes of rest, put the apricot jelly again to boil and add the lemon salt. The same pattern applies. For whole fruits, boil for 20 minutes on high heat. For spreadable jelly, let it boil for 35 minutes or 40 on low heat. If you have a food thermometer, check the temperature of the jelly after 20 minutes of boiling for option 1 and 40 minutes of boiling for option 2 to see if it reaches 105 degrees Celsius or 221 degrees Fahrenheit. If it did, then your jelly is done. If not, let it boil for another 5 to 10 minutes. If you don't have a food thermometer, try the plate taste. Put a plate into a freezer to cool. Add a few drops of jelly on the cold plate. If it thickens quickly, then it's done. Turn off the stove and add the vanilla. Let it cool off before filling up the jars. Another trick to make the apricot jelly last longer would be to add a coat of sugar before closing the lid. If you like the almond flavor, you can add a few apricot kernels. Or another option would be to flip over the jars for 10 minutes to create a seal and to make sure there aren't any spills. That's it, this is the apricot jelly. Thanks for watching, don't forget to subscribe, like and share.